future has a past. It's an exhibition, like no other exhibition.
It's looking at the future of Wales through the eyes of young people.
Mae'r arddangosfa hon yn rhan o brosiect ehangach sy'n cael ei ariannu gan Gronfa Trefnidiaeth y Glosri I roi llais I bobl ifanc yng ngwaith yr amgueddfa.
We also wanted to work with the idea of the Future Generations Act. Think about how museums can be part of that responsibility towards future generations. And received a donation which was to go towards youth-led activities. So that all came together and we then decided to work on an exhibition that wouldn't be curated by the traditional experts, but by young people and Henry Alice, the artist we recruited with young people on the recruitment board as well.
I'm Henry Alice, I'm a Dutch artist, theatre maker, performer. I work a lot with food. But above all, I work with people in the socially engaged concepts for many years. And it was a joy to work in Wales.
This was much more a multivocal project. So a lot of people were involved in it. We had a lead artist from the Netherlands. We had young people employed by the museum, who in turn employed young creatives, artists, people who were interested in writing and in film. And they all came together to work on this project to look at what is our vision of the future.
Yep. The exhibition is what came from a series of workshops with Henry Ellis. So for a while, like every week, we would meet up and we'd have sit-down meals where we'd bring something and then we'd talk, we'd do like research, and then from there, everyone kind of just like going to places and finding out about places in Wales, how they relate to other things.
Yeah. And so we worked all together and we bounced ideas to each other and stuff. And I think everyone kind of felt they were part of the team.
What the museum's collection has to offer in terms of being able to tell those stories through objects and also developing the artwork that will be a part of this exhibition.
I wouldn't really do thought all hefyd I weld sut o wahanol pobl yn interpretoriaeth Gymraeg ac yn gweld y cysyniad yma o Gymreictod traddodiadol. A dwi'n meddwl bod yn really let you weld sut oedden ni yn symud ffwrdd o'r binary concept yma o Gymreictod ac agor drysau gwahanol I drafod cyfieithu ac I drafod y iaith Gymraeg.
Like, I really like learning about language. I think the language of a culture reflects what they value. And certainly working on this project, looking at the history of Wales and the sort of community feel that's like not just exists today, but like it comes from the past. It comes from this constant value of collectivism in society. And I think, I don't know, something that's quite beautiful to have like that community feel reflected throughout history.
The exhibition, so the title The Future Has a Past, kind of before the pandemic, kind of had a very like different meaning, but now it's kind of I don't know, it was kind of weird like how we're doing an exhibition about something that kind of happened as well.
I mean, it's been a process of adapting, but that was the same with everybody really, so actually it kind of leveled the playing field. We were having video calls with people, regardless whether they were in Wales or not.
Oedd hi'n really cool I gael cyfrannu a gweithio yn greadigol ar y cyd hefo lots o bobl eraill o ganddiroedd gwahanol. Felly, oedd hi'n really cool I weld yr iaith yn cael ei ddathlu.
I think the biggest challenge of making a exhibition on the future is that it's too big. How can you actually, the future? And then of course the first response, of course, in cooperation with these wonderful young people and these themes that they already chosen that touch on diversity and other wonderful contemporary subjects. But then you look at the past and then you see that the past is just such a similar broad thing. We're in the now and then future, past, that's something, a real big thing to work on together. But I think we managed.
Llwyddiant y prosiect ydy bod llais o bobl ifanc yn cael eu clywed am y tro cyntaf yn Saint Fagan ac yn Amgueddfa Cymru. Ddim ni nath benderfynu beth oedd yn cael ei gynnwys, a ddim ni benderfynodd beth oedd y stori. Y bobl ifanc oedd yn wneud hyn, a y gobaith ydy bod pobl yn mynd i ddod i weld hwn ac yn meddwl, o, waw, am y tro cyntaf mae'n stori fi yn cael ei gynnwys yn Saint Fagan.
It's open to interpretation, it's open to discovery. There's a lot of elements that touch on different sides of Wales. It was an experiment, a moment to try something new, and a good way, I think, to start off this new contemporary gallery in St. Fagans as well.
Da ni yn gobeithio bydd y bobl ifanc yn parhau i gael eu cynnwys yn gwaith yr amgueddfa, a newid y ffordd da ni'n gweithio, ac efallai newid y ffordd mae amgueddfeidd yn cael eu gweld. Fel hen lefydd llawn llwch. Da ni yn bwriadu rhoi cic i'r llwch na, a dyna beth mae'r arddangosfa hon yn wneud.
When I think about collaboration with this exhibition, I generally think of choirs. And the concept of a choir is each singer has their own individual voice, but when they sing together, it becomes its own special group voice.
The way we worked on the project almost mirrored how society works as a whole in creating our histories, even though we may have different ideals for what outcomes we want. When we work and collaborate together, we can make something new and exciting.